If you have failed the real estate exam multiple of times and you're wondering why isn't it working, what other things can I do to be able to pass it? Well, I'm gonna give you guys some tips, so stay tuned. Hey everyone, my name is Stefanie Kebede. I'm a realtor in the state of Pennsylvania with Century 21 Realty Services. And before this video starts, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Go subscribe if you're not subscribed. Turn that bell button on so you guys never miss an upload. And with that being said, let's get right into today's video. Okay, so I've been getting a lot of people coming to me saying, what do I need to do? I failed the exam. I failed it a second time, a third time. What do I need to do to pass it? And for you guys to get a little backstory about me, I actually took the exam three times. On my third time, that was for the state, and I passed it finally, thank God. And then for my national, I took that the first time and I passed that, so thank God for that. And I just want to give you guys some things I did that may help you and be an impact in your, you know, studying and whatever you've been doing to see if that can boost your ability to pass it. So I just want to start going into the tips. And the first thing I recommend you guys doing is type in prep agent on YouTube. Now, prep agent, he has a whole bunch of other stuff, like you can buy, I guess, like online practice tests and stuff like that. I want to tell you guys that I did not buy anything. I had to save money, so I did not buy anything. You can buy it if you want, but for me, all I did was type in his name on YouTube. I subscribed to him and I went through almost all of his videos, and I started with vocab. Okay, so I started with vocab. I would listen to him asking the other people he was on the video call with, saying, okay, what is free simple? What is that? Or fee absolute, whatever, you know, all the vocab words are. But I would pause the video while I'm watching it. I would think of it. I would say it in my head, and then I'd say it out. And then I would press play, see if that was correct. If it was correct, then, you know, I'd write it down. Fee absolute means this. And you want, when you're writing these definitions down, he really wants you guys to write it like as brief as possible. Because when it's really brief, you're going to remember it easier and everything is just going to be easy for you, just because there's a lot of vocab out there. So make it brief as possible and use acronyms if need be. Okay. And that really helped me, just writing literally everything down, all the vocab, even if I knew it. If I knew, you know, what the bundle of rights were, knew that, but I still wrote it down just so I knew it like to the T. Okay, so make sure you guys go check him out on YouTube. I'll leave a link down in the description so you guys can go straight directly to his channel. Okay, and now the second thing I advise for you guys is do not overstudy. And, you know, the third time of me taking that state exam, I made sure to go to bed early, you know, around 8 o'clock, have my mind relax, because the next day I took that exam around 5 o'clock and I just relaxed most of the day. You know, if a thought came to my mind about, wait, what's this, then I hurried up, I look it up, and then, you know, I get the answer, then I relax. Okay, so you guys don't want to stress your mind out. You guys don't want to be filled with stress, so go meditate, go relax. Eat a good breakfast, eat healthy, do not eat anything bad, because that just, it messes with your brain and how you think, so be aware of that. Another thing that I haven't worried about, and what a lot of people don't say you should worry about, is the math. They usually have a couple of math questions, and it's normally on the national exam. I don't think I saw any math on the state exam, but if you miss the math, it's okay. You'll be fine. As long as you know how to calculate like commission and stuff like that, it's super easy. Go check out my money video on how much we make money in real estate. I show you how to calculate the commission. So check that out. I'll put the link right here. But you don't need to worry about the math, so don't stress about that at all. And another question you guys been asking me is about the CE shop, because that's where I took my online classes, my courses for pre-licensing. And after that, they do have a state licensing practice like exam for their course, because when you're done taking their course, you have to take an exam, and they have a practice exam for that exam, and they also have a national exam for, you know, for them as well. And I would just go through those multiple times, just to refresh my mind about real estate. And you guys are asking me, are those the same questions on the CE shop? Are they the same as the actual state and national exam? And no, they are not. They're not even, you know, close to it at all. But I just took it a lot just to get my mind refreshed and just got my mind thinking about real estate. And, you know, it gives you like the broad definitions and stuff like that. So yeah, it played a part. Maybe it helped a little bit. But the main thing that really helped was prep agent. So guys, just writing everything down and saying it out loud, that really helped me. Just talking it out, act like you're the teacher. Because when you're the teacher and you're saying everything, that's when you really remember things, okay? So be aware of that, guys. I hope these little tips helped you. Like I said, I didn't do so much, but just writing things down has really helped me. But let me know if you guys have any other questions down below in the comments, or DM me on Instagram as well. But with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.